Time for a brand new episode of everybody's favorite web show, The Smorgasborg.
Oh, you can barely get 100 views, you scrub.
It's time for some Smorgasborg, if you know what I'm saying. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the second week of The Smorgasborg. And let me tell you, we got a fun packed day filled today. We're going to go over a story of when just buying a regular old Super Soaker was not good enough for me. We're going to talk about Pokemon Sword and Shield for the Giga Game of the Week, as well as the JPC Classic Highlight. We're going to end it off with a brand new segment to finish off the show. First thing, starting things off with a classic bring back from next week with a thing called Story Time. It's a time that's a story, but also a story. It's story time! So this story dates back to the year 2013, where school had just let off, and me and my friend group decided that what better way to kick things off than a water war. Not to be mistaken with Waterworld. Everybody broke off and equipped up, got their gear ready for the big day. And I sat there and I looked at the Super Soakers at Walmart and I just thought, I can't just show up with a pincy little pistol or some little Super Soaker shotgun. And so rather than getting just like a Super Soaker to use, what I ended up going for was what I'm calling, because that's what the box said, a multi-purpose sprayer. Okay, now it was a big ass cylinder and it's what people use basically when they fertilize their lawns. My theory was if I could take this contraption, rig it into a backpack, that essentially I would eliminate having to fill up these Super Soakers like everybody else. Here's where things get dicey. So we're having the war, things are going great, I'm running around spraying people, the machine is working perfectly, I'm defending the flag, nobody can even come near me because I just have a constant like pressure washer of water just spraying everywhere. Until I'd say 3/4 of the way through the battle when I finally drained my entire tank of water. Like, I drained it and I realized, okay, you know what? In order to finish this off, I'm gonna have to fill this up. There was only one place to fill up with water in the park, and that was at the water park, you know, where parents bring their kids to have a lovely afternoon. And so I showed up there, turned on the tap, started filling up my giant, you know, colander of water, this raid container. And I started realizing that as I'm filling it up, more and more moms are pulling their kids out of the pool and kind of leaving and giving me these looks, you know, like the classic looks, you know, like the ones like as they're walking away, like out of the corner of their eye. And I realized, okay, you know what? I don't know what pissed them off, but they're kind of upset. At this point, I'm oblivious. I'm filling my water tank, cackling to myself because I thought of the best water gun. Until finally I see one mom approaching me and she comes up and I'm like, okay, well, I guess I'm going to finally figure out what they're upset about. And then her words are, "You can't really be that dumb, can ya?" And this kind of catches me off guard, because you know what? At this point, I'm probably feeling the smartest I've ever felt. Like, I just created the best water gun in the world, and I'm thinking, like, I'm on the level of Einstein and shit. And this person says I can't really be that dumb. And then she follows up with, "That's not actually a fertilizer container." And this is when I start seeing the bigger picture, okay? So I have a container that's known for fertilizing that has a fertilizer brand on the side and like a poisonous emblem, and I'm filling it up in a kid's water park. And that's when it hit me and I realized, oh no, all of these people, all of these moms think that I'm literally filling up and washing out a fertilizer container that's poisonous in a park for kids. And I immediately apologize to the lady. I say, "I'm sorry." I tell her that it's not ever been used for fertilizer. It's my multi-purpose water sprayer and it's a water gun. And she finally starts to understand it. But you know, you can still tell that she's just like, who the hell is this kid? But I still stand to my day that it was the best water gun I ever had. And it's a multi-purpose water sprayer, not a fertilizer. So I did nothing wrong. But so that's it for story time this week. If you guys have any stories that I've told you in the past or that you would love to hear again, please drop them in the comments below, and I'll make sure to have one ready again for next week. But that's it for story time, and so now we're going to go to everybody's favorite segment, Giga Games. The game is the Giga Game. Yeah! Oh yeah! Hello everybody, and welcome to Giga Games, everyone's favorite gaming thing of the week. And today, we have a lot of fun planned. Notice I changed the hat because it's a gaming hat. Buy one. Today we're starting things off with the Giga Game of the Week, and that is Pokemon Sword and Shield. Now, I'm a huge time Pokemon supporter, love the series, been playing it since Game Boy Color,
And I just recently picked up a Switch and decided that, you know what, it's time to get into Pokemon Sword and Shield. And after playing Pokemon Sword and Shield, I gotta say that it was actually a really solid title. The campaign in that felt like it went a little quick at times, and reading online, I realized that I would have to expect that there wasn't going to be all of the Pokemon. Like, they had a real, kind of like they narrowed down their selection, but this didn't affect the game for me too much really at all, because it was just really nice to be able to explore these giant wild worlds. And I liked the introduction of the raid encounters, and they still have my boys, Wobbuffet and Ludicola. Ludicrous! And so I really enjoyed the game, and I found that after I beat the campaign that it was probably one of the Pokemons to me that had the most replayability, because after you finish the campaign, it almost felt like the game had just opened up another can, because now you can start doing these max raid battles where you're getting higher and better quality Pokemon, and you can do those with friends. I felt like they made the breeding in this Pokemon a lot more accessible, so now all of a sudden you can breed your Pokemon for competitive play a lot faster and easier than what it would have been on other games. And to me, probably the best point was that once the game was done, it was one of the first Pokemons I've had in a while where there was full online multiplayer, where you could take your boys and your Pokemon and battle against other people online at basically any time. So for me, I really enjoyed Pokemon Sword and Shield, and I would definitely recommend it to people who love the Pokemon series and want to really see it in a bigger world than how it's been in handheld games. So that's the Giga Game for this week, and that throws us into the next bit, which is the JPC highlight of the week. So the JPC highlight of the week is a throwback to about a month ago. Me and the guys were playing Call of Duty, and I just started up a Twitch account, and so I was trying to get some more followers, and as we're playing, one of my friends mentions that if we hit 30 followers, that JPC will indeed shave his mustache live on Twitch. And so at this point, I was like, you know what, whatever. If I can get like 5 or 6 followers, I'll shave my mustache. And so the boys went to work, and this is what happened.
If I reach 30 followers on Twitch tonight, I'll shave my stash live.
Perfect. You're going to get a follower.
Come over
right
then, and we're shaving it.
Yeah, you got 3 followers right here, bro. You got 3
okay,
followers.
Okay, so if you want to see that mustache get shaved.
It's real shitty too, man. It's probably a blessing in disguise, but I'll paint myself up like Grimace. I think that'd be a good choice.
And if you get 30, we're gonna spray paint you chrome, all right?
Mark Survey.
Just plain cheese. I just saw myself.
You all helped me reach 30 followers, and for that, we will shave this beloved face. All right.
Oh yeah. Yes, do it. Let's go.
Here he goes.
Oh, it looks great.
Looks good.
Oh, that looks. Oh, you gotta clean it up, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you clean it up?
You gotta clean it up there, bro.
Leave the goatee.
Looking fresh. Daddy in chat really said, what else is that vibrator tool do?
That's it for Giga Games this week, so tune in next week, and if you have any games that you would recommend or want to see as the Giga Game of the Week, throw them in down below, because we always looking for stuff to play, if you know what I'm saying. It's everybody's favorite time of TV. It's commercial break. Welcome to Commercial Break, a brand new segment that we're starting up where we take 30 seconds of your time to interrupt this broadcast with a homemade commercial brought to you by yours truly, JPU, in the Just Plain Universe.
Can we have a snack?
I don't know. Let's see what we have. Man, we have Alphagetti's.
Sweet!
Man, I haven't had Alphagetti's since like grade 5. It only takes 1 minute. Here's your Alphagetti's.
Give me all your Alphagetti's. They're so cheesy, tomatoey, clean, and delicious.
You're the Alphagetti Goblin.
That wraps up everything this week. You know, we got the Giga Games in, we introduced the new segment, which we're gonna have a lot of fun with, and we went through the story of the week. And so, that wraps up everything this week on the Smorgasborg, and we'll be back next week with some fantastic, funny content. So, till then, bye-bye!